Direct detection has revolutionized electron microscopy by dramatically improving the quality of acquired data. But how does this technology translate to electron energy loss spectroscopy, or EELS? In this short whiteboard video, I'd like to carefully evaluate the current options for direct detection in EELS to see if any current direct detectors are well suited for EELS. My name is Benjamin Baumus, Director of Research and Development at Direct Electron. Our company pioneered direct detection over a decade ago, and we continue to push the boundaries of this groundbreaking technology to make it more effective and easier to use for a wide range of scientific applications. All our cameras use our own unique direct detection sensor designs, available nowhere else. As you know, EELS is a technique in transmission electron microscopy where electrons are passed through a specimen and then through a spectrometer, which bends the electrons by varying amounts depending on their energy, distributing them across a detector. The total detected intensity across each column of the detector corresponds to a different amount of electron energy loss. Plotting the results looks something like this. Typically, there's a very intense peak centered at zero, corresponding to the large number of unscattered or elastically scattered electrons having no energy loss. Then there's a region of peaks and valleys with intermediate intensity, called the low loss region. And finally, a region of very weak signal called the core loss region, which actually extends far beyond the end of our little example plot here. Capturing this data turns out to be quite challenging, though, due to the wide range of intensities in the EELS spectrum. If we replot the EELS spectrum on a log scale, the issue becomes obvious. The intensity of the EELS spectrum often spans three orders of magnitude or more. An effective EELS detector must therefore have a wide dynamic range, so that it can capture the very intense zero loss peak, the intermediate low loss region, and the very weak core loss region. Aha! If dynamic range is a critical requirement, then perhaps hybrid pixel detectors are the solution. After all, the major advantage of hybrid pixel detectors is their great dynamic range. Unfortunately, this turns out to be a no-go. Because they have very large pixels, hybrid pixel detectors are limited to very small array sizes. Many hybrid detectors have between 128 and 512 columns or channels available, which means that you'd actually be left with a very short spectrum. In fact, with so few channels, the dynamic range isn't even necessary, because you simply don't have enough channels to capture a spectrum wide enough to cover a large intensity range. Although there are a few recent hybrid pixel detectors that are larger, it remains infeasible to manufacture a hybrid detector with 4K channels, let alone actually fitting something that large on the end of a spectrometer. So while there are good applications for hybrid pixel detectors, EELS is clearly not one of them. These detectors are simply too small to be useful. So then, what about other direct detection cameras, like the kind used for biological cryo-EM? Those cameras are typically about 4K by 4K in size, offering nearly an order of magnitude more channels for EELS than a hybrid pixel detector. And they have great sensitivity because they operate with electron counting. In fact, there are already a few publications where these cameras have been used for EELS, showing significant benefits in resolving weak high-loss signals. So that must be the answer, right? Not so fast. Remember that EELS covers a wide dynamic range, three or more orders of magnitude, for the entire energy spectrum. If you want to do more than just a few niche, super low dose or high loss experiments, you must have a detector that can accommodate a wide range of intensities. So, do these counting detectors that were originally designed for low dose biological cryo-EM fit the bill? Let's see. Dynamic range in a detector is defined as the ratio between the maximum intensity that can be practically acquired and the minimum intensity that can be practically acquired. Note the caveat of practically. It's important. For example, it's certainly possible for a camera manufacturer to state that their camera can acquire an image with 1,000 electrons per pixel per frame. Technically, they aren't lying. You can get an image from the camera when you illuminate it with that intense of a beam. But will that image be any good? Absolutely not. It will likely be saturated and completely worthless for the purpose of your experiment. So what we're interested in is looking at numbers that will be useful for you in practice. Let's look at dynamic range then, the ratio between the maximum and minimum practical exposures on the camera. The minimum looks impressive for these direct detection counting cameras. To varying degrees, depending on the camera's noise level, these cameras are single electron sensitive, able to detect the vast majority of electrons incident on the detector. For weak signals, to a first approximation, the signal-to-noise ratio is simply limited by Poisson statistics. That is, the signal-to-noise ratio is proportional to the square root of the number of detected electrons. Let's assume that we need a signal-to-noise ratio of at least 3 in any given channel in order to resolve features in our EELS spectrum. Thus, each channel must have at least 9 electrons. So that's the minimum practical exposure on the detector. Now, how about the maximum? For the EELS spectrum to be interpretable, the detector must be linear. In other words, the signal detected in each channel must be proportional to the number of electrons with the energy of that channel. It's known that electron counting direct detectors lose linearity as the exposure rate increases. Some manufacturers actually give this away by calling their integrating mode linear mode, in contrast to counting mode. Figures from Lee et al. In a 2013 JSB paper showed that linearity within plus or minus 10% requires an exposure rate of no more than 0.015 electrons per pixel per frame. So let's use that as our maximum for counting. Remember, it's certainly possible to acquire images with a brighter beam than that, but the data will quickly lose its utility as linearity is lost. If the detector is 4,096 pixels high, then there are 4,096 pixels per channel in the EELS spectrum. And if the internal frame rate of the camera is 1,500 frames per second, and each EELS spectrum is read out to the computer at 75 frames per second, then there are 20 counted frames per EELS spectrum when operating the camera at full speed. Multiplying these values together gives you a maximum exposure rate of about 1,230 electrons per channel. We'll plug that value into our ratio for dynamic range, and doing the math, we find that the dynamic range of an electron counting direct detector is 137. Eek! That's really low. So how does that look for EELS data? Not so good. While these detectors perform really nicely for weak signals, they simply cannot accommodate higher intensities. Best case, the zero loss peak in the low loss region will be hard to interpret due to the detector's poor linearity. Worst case, these regions will completely saturate the detector. Certainly, weak signals look much better on these detectors than conventional detectors, allowing users to detect core loss edges at much higher energy, even up to 10,000 EV. So that's really exciting. But that excitement quickly dwindles when you realize how limiting these detectors are. So, are there any better options? Let's go back and rehash the requirements for a good EELS detector. The detector should have lots of channels, like 4K channels, so that your spectrum has sufficient resolution to detect features of interest. The detector should have exceptional sensitivity so that it can detect weak signals, especially in high loss regions of the spectrum. And finally, the detector should have sufficient dynamic range to capture the entire spectrum for many different EELS experiments. Let me introduce you to the DE16 direct detection camera, built around our 10th generation DDD sensor technology, which is only available from our company, Direct Electron. The DE16 has 4096 by 4096 pixels, giving you 4K channels for your EELS spectrum. It delivers high signal-to-noise ratio with single electron sensitivity. In fact, we uniquely designed this detector to reduce sensor noise even further than other detectors by designing the sensor with on-chip correlated double sampling, or CDS. Uniquely, in the DE16, each pixel senses and subtracts its own reset noise before sending data out of the sensor to the computer. This noise subtraction gives the DE16 impressively low noise, even compared to other direct detectors. The reduced false positive rate on the DE16 is absolutely critical for squeezing everything you can out of weak signals. Last but not least, the DE16 has exceptional dynamic range. See, we didn't design the DE16 specifically for a low-dose biological cryo-EM, and then just try to adapt it for other applications. No. We designed the DE16 with the versatility necessary for a wide range of applications, from in situ TEM, to electron diffraction, to 4D STEM, to EELS. And it turns out in the process, we also got a camera that works really well for low-dose imaging too. One of the technologies that we've implemented in the DE16 is what we call HDR counting. This patent-pending technology allows us to simultaneously acquire weak signals with electron counting mode in order to maximize the signal-to-noise ratio, while also acquiring intense signals with integrating mode, which maintains linearity for much, much higher exposure rates. With our unique HDR counting mode, the DE16 is always acquiring both integrating and counting data, and it automatically chooses the optimal mode for each channel in each frame. So how does that look for EELS? Remember that a typical EELS spectrum spans about 3 orders of magnitude or more. For weak signals, such as those in the core loss region, the detector will choose to operate in counting mode so that the signal-to-noise ratio in these channels is absolutely optimized. If the entire detector operated in counting mode, as it does for other direct detection cameras, the maximum exposure where linearity is maintained would only be about 1,230 electrons per channel. That's simply not enough for EELS. But the DE16 can acquire more intense signals using integrating mode, increasing its maximum exposure to more than 60,000 electrons per channel per frame. For comparison, that's about a 50-fold improvement over other counting direct detectors. Finally, we have a detector well-suited for EELS. Large, exceptional signal-to-noise ratio and resolution, and sufficient dynamic range to capture EELS spectra. Direct detectors are certainly exciting, but how does this technology translate to EELS? Well, hybrid pixel detectors are well-suited to certain applications, but EELS is not one of them. These detectors are simply too small to be useful for EELS. Counting direct detectors, originally designed for low-dose biological cryo-EM, show more promise. These are large enough and also deliver really nice performance for weak signals. But these detectors are severely limited to a small niche of experiments because they simply lack the necessary dynamic range to be truly useful for EELS. We believe we hit the sweet spot with the DE16. It's large, it has exceptional signal-to-noise ratio and resolution, and it has sufficient dynamic range. Finally, a direct detector that is designed for EELS. For more information, please see our website. Better yet, send us an email and start a conversation. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised by what we have to offer. Plus, we love hearing from you because it helps us continue to develop future innovations to help propel your scientific discoveries.